Decent jobs are important for reducing poverty and inequality. They also impact on citizen empowerment and personal well-being. But populations are growing. Globally, 600 million new jobs will have to be created over the next 15 years just to keep employment rates constant. We need to understand how to generate more and better jobs and ensure that disadvantaged groups are not left out. One way is to learn from what works, from countries that have made impressive progress today. In Sri Lanka, despite difficult conditions, including a long-standing conflict, unemployment fell from 15% in 1992 to just 4% in 2012. Wages increased by a fifth between 2006 and 2012, while employment opportunities for women rose. Progress has been made possible by promoting investment, prioritizing education to upskill workers, and orientating the market towards exports such as garments. Migration has also helped to relieve pressures in the local labor market, although there are at times concerns for workers' welfare overseas. To sustain the progress made, Sri Lanka needs to retain its competitiveness, raise productivity, and attract further investment. Increasing access to employment opportunities, particularly for youth and women, should also be a focus for the future. In Uganda, there are also signs of employment progress over the last two decades. Strong management of the economy since the 1990s has ensured relatively rapid and inclusive growth. This has been accompanied by developments in banking, telecommunications, and transport. Wage employment in Uganda increased from 14% of total employment in 2003 to 24% in 2009. The quality of jobs has also dramatically improved as more and more households move away from agriculture and get their income from other sources. Productivity doubled between 1990 and 2010, as did the total labor force, rising from 7.5 million in 1990 to 14.5 million by 2012. Challenges do remain. Employment in Uganda remains largely agrarian, accounting for 3/4 of the workforce, but only 1/4 of GDP. Progress also needs to be achieved at a larger scale due to high population growth. On average, Ugandan women have over 6 children, and opportunities need to be extended to the young in particular. Both countries have shown how it is possible to increase employment opportunities, even from a low base. Emerging technologies and markets are providing new opportunities. The challenge now will be to broaden access to decent work, extend opportunities to excluded groups, and sustain the progress made. Find out more lessons at developmentprogress.org.